knowledge is acquired by day-to-day hands-on experiences. We, the Carmelites, believe that observing physics is the best way to learn physics. So we, the students of Class 10C of Carmel Convent Senior Secondary School, Ratanpur, are here to present our activity-based demonstrations.
And all my dear friends, today, Anjita Negi of Class 10C is here to perform an activity on a topic, Refraction of Light. In this activity, we need a bottle, a coin and a ball. Now, take a bowl on a table and put a coin on it. Then, move slowly away from the table. Stop when you are not able to see the coin. Now, let's put some water on it. Without disturbing a coin. Now, you can able to see the coin clearly due to the phenomena known as the refraction of light. The refraction of light is a bending of light when an incident ray obliques on a interface of two medium, due to which the coin is rise slightly above from its actual position.
Good morning, teachers and dear students. I am Tamanna Rajput of Class 10C and I am here to present an activity to show Tyndall effect. First, we should know what is Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect is a light scattering by particles in a colloid or a very fine suspension. Now, let's perform an activity. Take two glasses filled with water, few drops of milk and a torch. Add milk in a solution. Now this is solution A and this is solution B. Now we are focusing a torch in the solution and see the light is visible here. Now it's a turns of solution B. See, we cannot see any light passing here. Now, what do we observe throughout the activity? We observe that the light is not passing through the second solution, which is solution B. Because of the particles in the solution do not allow the light to pass through the solution. Okay, that's all for today. Have a nice and joyful day ahead.
Morning, respected ma'am. Today, I am Mehak Agrawal and I am here to demonstrate an activity on the topic splitting of white light into 7 component colors. So, the material required for the activity are
torch, a CD and a white paper.
So, here we are going to see that white light when passed through a prism on which is now passing through a CD which is acting like a prism split into 7 constituent colors. So here we can observe that when white light is passed through a prism split into 7 constituent colors, which is known as...
Good morning everyone. Today I am Urshini Rajput of Class 10C. Today I am going to perform an activity based on Tyndall effect. So without wasting time, let's get straight to the activity.
Sure.
Material required for the activity are two glasses filled with water, laser light and some amount of milk.
That.
As we can see... the light on wall, but we are unable to see the path of light in the glasses. But when we will add milk in one of the glass of water, we can actually see the path of light in the glass. This is due to Tyndall effect. Thank you.
Good morning, respected teachers and dear friends. I am Pihu Pahade of Class 10C, here to demonstrate an activity regarding refractive index. So let's start. The first question arises, what is refractive index? The extent of change in direction that takes place in given pair of media is expressed in terms of refractive index. So the materials required are a glass half filled with water and a laser beam. Here we can see that when we put the laser beam in water, it gets refracted towards normal. As we have seen in first activity, the beam gets refracted towards the normal. This is because the water is more denser than the air. The density of water is 1.33 and the density of air is 1.0003. As in the figure, when light travels from rarer to denser medium, it reflects towards the normal. But when light travels from denser to rarer medium, it travels away from the normal. That's all we have seen in the activity. Thank you.
Good morning to respected teacher and all my dear friends. Today, Anushka Gohil of class 10C is here to demonstrate an activity on the topic splitting of white light into its 7 component colors. So, to demonstrate this activity, the material required are torch, a white paper, and a compact disc that is a CD that will act like a prism. So we have seen in the activity that when we put the torchlight in front of the CD, it split the white light into a beautiful band of color, and this band of color is known as spectrum. Thank you so much.
Good morning to one and all. This is Devyani Pal of class 10C. I'm here to do the activity on the topic Tyndall effect. The materials required are a torch, 2 glasses filled with water named as A and B, 1 bowl which is having some milk, and a tablet which will act like a screen. So, first we will put the torch on, and we can see that the light is coming on the screen. We can see that the light is coming on the screen and passing through the water. Now, second step, if we put some milk in B glass and then try to pass the light through it, it is not possible. The light is not coming on the screen.
Sorry.
The scattering of light by the particles in a colloidal or suspension is called a Tyndall effect. This is only possible when the size of a particle is greater than the wavelength of the light used. True solutions do not show the Tyndall effect, as their particle size is very small to scatter the light falling on them. Hope you will like my project. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay home.
A very hearty good morning to respected teacher and all my dear friends. Today, I, Anya Verma of class 10C, is here to represent a physics practical. In this physics practicals, the materials required are a coin, a glass bowl, and water. In this practical, I will drop a coin in the bowl filled with water and try to pick it up in a first go. Let's see if I can pick it in a first go or not. So, I was not able to pick the coin in the water in the first go. It is because of refraction. When a light travels from a medium to another medium, it causes refraction, which causes the object to displace from its place. As the light passes from the air to water, that is why I was not able to pick up the coin in the water in the first go.
Good morning, ma'am. Here I am, Poonvi Sharma from class 10C. Here I am presenting our activity in the basis of Tyndall effect. Now I have taken a salt solution and a soap solution. We have to close the light for a clear appearance. Now, first I will take a soap solution, salt solution. We can see clearly that there is a no Tyndall effect. And in soap solution, we can clearly see that there is a Tyndall effect. It is because a ray of light are reflected off the surface of this soap solution and move different direction. Thank you.
A very warm good morning to respected teachers and to all my dear friends.
Today, I, Parampara Kadam of class 10th C, am here to demonstrate an activity based on splitting of white light into its 7 color components. So, for doing this activity, the material required are a torch or a flashlight, a cardboard which is having a cut slit on it, and a television which will act like a prism. So, by doing this activity, we have observed that when white light is passed through a prism, it is splitted into its 7 color constituents. We know that the refractive index of prism for different colors, it is different. White light is a polychromatic and composite light having different colors, each with different wavelengths. When white light is passed through prism, it is splitted into its 7 color constituents by refracting at different angles, thus forming a spectrum, which is a band of 7 colors, can also be recognized by the acronym WIBCure. Thank you so much.
A very hearty good morning to respected teachers and all my dear friends. Today, Deepa Sharma of class 10C is here to demonstrate our activity, which is based on the path of light when it travels through a convex lens. To demonstrate this activity, we need a convex lens and a source of light. As we can see, when I adjust the lens, a bright spot appears. This is the image of the light source that I am using. This shows that the light rays which are parallel to the principal axis after refraction passes through the focus. Now, let us understand the concept with the help of diagram. As you can see, the light rays which are parallel to the principal axis after refraction passes through the focus.
A very hearty good morning to my teacher and all my dear classmates. Today, I am Jayak Arora and I am here to perform an activity based on the reflection of an image from a plane mirror. So, material required are a plain cardboard, white plain cardboard, a white paper sheet, a comb and a flashlight. Place the white cardboard in front of the mirror and put the comb like this on the cardboard and make sure that the distance between the mirror and the comb is 15 to 20 centimeter. Now place the flashlight behind the comb and now we are able to see the reflection and hence the dark lines are the incident ray and the light ones are the reflected ray. Now I will zoom it and show you the rays. These are the incident rays and you can see here the rays are reflecting back. These are the reflected rays.
Good morning teachers, today Abhay Katiyar of class 10th is here to demonstrate an activity based on splitting of white light into 7 colors. For this activity, the materials required are a flashlight or torch, a cardboard which has a cut slit at the center and a black screen which will act like a prism. As we observe that when we turn on the light from black screen, it splits into its 7 color. The splitting of white light into 7 color is called dispersion.
Good morning to ma'am. Today I, Pradeep Kaur of class 10C, I am here to demonstrate an activity that light travel in a straight line. Material required are a sheet which is rolled in cylindrical shape, another sheet is also rolled in cylindrical shape but bent from the middle, and a lightning candle. A sheet which is rolled in cylindrical shape in straight, another sheet which is bent from the middle. So we have observed that a sheet which is straight, light passes through it, and another sheet which is bent from the middle, the light does not pass through it, hence light travel in a straight line. Thank you.
I am Pranav Goswami of class 10C, present here to give my demonstration on the topic, the splitting of white light into its 7 components. You can see the disc that is having 7 colors. Due to the wavelength of the light, we can see the red light and violet light most, violet light least and red light most due to the wavelength. That is, thank you.
And to all my dear friends, today I am Jatin Gaur of class 10C is here to demonstrate an activity on topic index of refraction. So let's go.
For this activity are 3 glasses, you can see that, in which water is present, in the other one ice water is present, and the other one oil is present. We need a glass slab also for this activity. I don't have a glass slab, but I am using the pen's body foot to demonstrate this activity. It will act like a glass slab only. To start this activity, I will take this pen's body to start this activity. Now I will dip this pen in this water. You can see that the glass, the pen's body can be easily seen outside the glass. The ice water comes and the water goes. Now we will do this activity with this ice water. Now I will dip this pen's body in this ice water. Now you can see that the pen also can be easily seen outside the glass. Now I will do this activity with this oil. You can see this. Now I will dip this pen's body in this oil. Now you can see that the oil, the pen body cannot be seen outside the glass. Activity, we have concluded that the glass slab can be easily seen in water and ice water, but not in oil, because the refractive index of water and ice is less than that of...
A very warm good morning to respected teachers and to all my dear friends. Today, I, Parampara Kadam of class 10C, am here to demonstrate an activity based on splitting of white light into its 7 color components. So, for doing this activity, the material required are a torch or a flashlight, a cardboard which is having a cut slit on it, and a television which will act like a prism. So, by doing this activity, we have observed that when white light is passed through a prism, it is split into its 7 color constituents. We know that the refractive index of prism for different colors, it is different. White light is a polychromatic and composite light having different colors, each with different wavelengths. When white light is passed through prism, it is split into its 7 color constituents by refracting at different angles, thus forming a spectrum, which is a band of 7 colors, can also be recognized by the acronym WIBGYOR. Thank you so much.
Good morning. Dear respected teacher, today I, Palak Chauhan of class 10C, is here to demonstrate an activity for refraction of light. Refraction is a change in the direction of wave passing from one medium to another, or from a gradual change in the medium. Refraction of light has certain laws. The incident ray, the refracted ray, and the normal to the interface of two transparent media at the point of incidence all lie in the same plane. Second, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is a constant for the light of a given color and for the given pair of media. This law is also known as Snell's law of reflection. This is true for angle 0 greater than I greater than 90 degree. If I is the angle of incidence and R is the angle of refraction, then sin I R upon sin R equals constant. Now, let us start the activity to understand the refraction of light more easily. materials required for the activity are a glass, a pencil, and a water. Procedure is that put water in the glass that it will just fill half. Now, put the pencil in the glass which is filled with water. Now, observe it. While putting the pencil in the glass, the pencil looks like it is broken. But actually, when we remove it from the water, it looks like it is okay. Now, the observation comes. The observation was that when the pencil is put it into water, it looks like it's broken, but actually it was not broken. It was a reflection of light. As a light passes from rare medium to the denser medium, air is the rare medium and water is the denser medium. When light passes from rare medium to the denser medium, the direction changes. This shows the reflection of light. Thanks.
A very hearty good morning to teachers and all my dear friends. Today, I am Gurdeep Singh from class 10C is here to perform an activity on the topic refraction. So, material required are a glass tumbler filled with water and a pencil. When the pencil is partly immersed in the water in a glass tumbler, it appears bent or broken to the observer. We know for the fact that the pencil is not bent at all. It just appears so. In this case, the light reaching observer from the portion of the pencil inside the water seems to be come from different direction as compared to the water. This is because when the light ray travels from one optical medium to another, it suffers a change in direction in the surface of the separation of the two media. This is known as refraction. This makes the pencil appear to be displaced at the interface.
Good morning all of you. I am Janvi Maheshwari and I am going to perform an activity on refraction of light. Material required for the following activity is a page with an arrow and a water of glass. Let us begin this activity. When this arrow passes through water of glass, what happens? The arrow changes its direction. It changes its direction from right to left. Why is this so? Let us find out. We all know refraction is bending of light. In addition to glass of water, which acts as a magnifying glass, bends the light towards the center when it passes through focal point. And beyond focal point, the image looks reversed because the image which was facing towards right is now on left. Thank you. Hope you understood the activity.
Very hearty good morning to ma'am. Today, I, Garima Bhengare of class 10C, is going to perform an activity to demonstrate that light travels in a straight line. Materials required for this activity are a sheet which is rolled in a cylindrical shape, another sheet which is also rolled in a cylindrical shape but bent from middle, and a lighted candle. Firstly, take the cylindrical sheet which is straight. Then, take the sheet which is bent from middle. And observe it. So, we have observed that the cylindrical sheet which was straight, we can see light through it, but not through our sheet which was bent from middle. Hence, we conclude that light travels in a straight line. Thank you.
We often read in books that light travels in a straight line. Do you believe that? Have you observed that the beam of light entering inside a dark room through a tiny hole from the window? What do you see? Do you see light travels in a straight line? Hello friends, today we will perform an experiment to show that light travels in a straight line. All that we need to start the experiment are 3 old CDs, matchbox, candle, and 6 clips. So first of all, we will make a stand of these CDs. So for that, we will use clips. So now, we have to make stands using clip
like this. Align them in such a way that the tip of the candle should be visible. Now try to see the flame through the holes. What do you observe? You will observe that you can see the burning flame of candle. But how can you see the flame? Because light travels in a straight line. Now, what will happen when we displace the CD at the middle slightly? The moment we displace a bit, what happens? Are you still able to see the flame? No. What did that happen? That's because light come here and got blocked. Because we displaced the CD, so the light cannot able to come further and you are not able to see it.
Start.
Now, had light the ability to take curve turns? In that case, light should be take turn and then come through the hole and you could have seen it. But since light travels in a straight line, we are unable to see it. So this experiment clearly proves that the light travels in a straight line. Few important points while performing the experiment. First, old CD must be used. CD should be perpendicular to the table. Holes and the candle flame must be in a straight line. Thank you.
Very warm wishes to respected principal, teachers and my dear friends. Myself Aisha Khan of class 10C and I am here to illustrate the image formation by convex and concave mirror respectively. Instead of using any mirror, I am using the stainless steel spoon to visualize the image formation. Here the outward surface of this spoon is bulked towards outward and thus it will react like a convex mirror. And the inward surface of this spoon is bulked inward and will react like a concave mirror.
Now, when you look at the convex surface, a diminished, virtual and erect image of the object is formed. And when you look at the concave surface, a real and inverted image is formed.
So here we come to a conclusion that when we bring the object near or away from the convex mirror, every time the image formed will be virtual and erect, and the size of the image will always be smaller than the size of the object. And in concave mirror, when you take the object away, the image formed is real and inverted and the size of the image keeps on decreasing. But when you bring it very closer to the mirror, the image formed is virtual and erect and the size is comparatively large. So this was our activity to illustrate the image formation by convex and concave mirror. Thank you.
A heartily good morning to one and all. This is Aditi Verma of 10th C and I am going to perform activity on refraction of light through water medium. For this activity, the materials required are a small coin, a bowl and some water. Keep the coin at the bottom of the bowl. Push the bowl away from you till the wall of the bowl hides the coin. Stop pushing when you lose the side of the coin. Now, pour some water in the bowl slowly. What do you observe? The coin seems to be rising up in the bowl and is visible again. The wall of the bowl fails to hide it anymore. What just happened was that the light from the coin in the absence of water travels in a straight line. The wall of the bowl prevents it from being seen. When we pour water, light from the coin refracts as it comes out of water and bends. This bent beam of light reaches the eyes quite easily and so the coin can be seen. This phenomena of bending of light at the interface of two media is commonly known as refraction of light. It occurs because the speed of light is different in different medium.
Very warm wishes to all. Myself, Ashi Rani of Class 10C, and I am here to demonstrate an activity of physics from the chapter The Human Eye on the topic Tyndall Effect. The material required to perform this activity are 2 glasses of water, few drops of milk, and a source of light. Now, place 2 glasses of water and name them as A and B. Now, add few drops of milk in solution B. Now we have 2 glasses of solution A as water and B as a suspended solution. Now we'll focus a source of light on glass A as well as glass B and let us see what we'll observe. We observe that the solution A allows the beam of light to pass through it, but the solution B does not allow the beam of light to pass through it. Instead, it scatters the beam of light. Happened because when the beam of light strikes the milk particles, it gets scattered in the different directions. So the light beam does not get any path to pass through the solution B. But in solution A, there was no suspendicular particle to strike the beam of light. So the beam of light passes easily through the solution A. Thank you. This was the activity to demonstrate the Tyndall effect.
We would like to express our special thanks of gratitude to our respected physics teacher, Mrs. Bindu Rajiv ma'am, and our school principal, Sister Kripa, who gave us this opportunity to learn and express.